Good day, class. I want to take you through energy changes and its effect for this class. You are familiar with chemical reactions. You know some things about chemical reactions, the rates of chemical reactions, the factors that affect chemical reactions. Now, energy. As known to everybody that it is the ability or capacity to do work. From the topic, the energy change version of one form of energy into another one. And this is seen in everyday life. For instance, use this energy to talk. You know, you students, this energy, when you want to report a particular person is eyeing you, what you are using is energy. The chemical energy in you is being converted into sound energy. We have different forms of energy. We have, like I said, we have chemical energy. We have energy in form of heat, that is thermal energy. We have light energy, heat energy. Light energy in your electric bulb, heat energy in your electric heater, and the other forms of energy also. Now, let's go back to conservation of energy. That is, energy is neither created nor destroyed. We want to limit ourselves to thermochemical reactions. That is reactions that have to do with heat. You will see hydrogen of the chemical equation, hydrogen plus oxygen to give you a molecule of water. The energy change that takes place is indicated by that. Now, the water molecule formed during electrolysis can also to give you hydrogen and oxygen. You can see that in splitting water molecule back to hydrogen and oxygen. That is law of conservation of energy. No permanent loss of energy. Exothermic reaction. Action. It has to do with something to be feasible. There must be absorption of heat from the surrounding medium. Why the opposite is exit? The two are opposite processes, which is endothermic. The other one vibrates or evolves. And that is exothermic reaction. Now, when you see chemical equations written down, how will you be able to distinguish exothermic from endothermic reactions? Now, endo, I said it has to do with absorption of heat, and you indicate positive. You indicate absorption, that is gain, by using positive, meaning that when you see a reaction and in front a particular value is given and that is positive, it means it is gained from the surrounding. That is the meaning. If you look at this, the second equation, this 85.5 kilojoule per mole energy is added. That is endothermic reaction. It receives heat from the surrounding. Then, considering the one that is up, you will see minus 285.58 kilojoule per mole, meaning that heat is evolved. It is given out to the surrounding. You indicate loss by negative. That is how to identify or distinguish exothermic from endothermic reactions. Now, to buttress my definition of endothermic and exothermic reaction, this illustration explains them better. You will see the two, you see in one that the arrows are pointing outwards, meaning that it is liberated to the surrounding. Arrows pointing outward, heat liberating into the surrounding. That is exothermic, loss of heat to the surrounding. While the other one is the opposite, the arrows are pointing inwards into the conical flask, meaning that heat energy is being absorbed from the surrounding. That is illustrated. Also, how can you demonstrate exothermic and endothermic reaction? If you look at my as it is, you will see moving from here up to here, you are moving from left to right. And you are familiar with normal chemical equations that reactants are on the left-hand side while the products are on the right-hand side, meaning that this one represents a chemical equation in which this is reactant side, reactants are here, this is product side. If you look at this, product is at higher level while reactants are at lower level. If you, now, let me say this, this heat change we are talking about, we call it enthalpy. Enthalpy, that means heat, and it is denoted by delta H. You know the symbol for delta, delta like triangle, then H, that is delta H. That is, that delta indicates change. YH, that is heat energy, is equal to heat of the product minus heat of the reactant. Heat of the product minus heat of the reactant. That is enthalpy change. You can see it. Yes. Heat of the product minus heat of the reactant. Now, back to my illustration. If this is the product now, the product is higher than the reactant, meaning that if you find the difference, product minus reactant, that is going to give you a positive value. A positive value, which means this, the reaction illustrated by this chemical equation is an endothermic change. And if you look at this, the other one like this, and you know, normally, reaction, chemical equation, we move from left to right, from left to right. Here, this is my product here. Why here? Here now, this is my reactant, because moving like this is from left to right when you follow it like this. Telling you reactants are at higher level while the products are at lower level. Find the difference, product minus reactant. A lower value minus a higher value will give you negative, meaning that the reaction illustrated by this and the surrounding. Having understood exothermic and endothermic changes, let's look at some reactions. Some reactions that involve exothermic and endothermic changes. Now, it is liberated. This is a typical reaction. to give hydrogen and oxygen. It's an endothermic change because heat is absorbed, and that is seen by addition sign. Now, the next thing we want to look at, the one I demonstrated with my hands is this. If you look at D2, you will see that the one in which you have the reactant above and the product down, so that when you find a difference, you get negative sign. That is exothermic change. That is the heat of formation of reactants is greater than the heat of formation of products. While the other one, in which the heat of formation of products is greater than change, in which heat is absorbed from the surrounding. Now, all these changes, we have heat, and the heat is involved in so many reactions, including neutralization, combustion, and so many other reactions. When the heat that is liberated with half mole of oxygen to give you water, that is heat of formation. You can see a molecule of water is gotten at the end of the reaction. That is heat of formation. Heat of formation is the heat liberated in getting a molecule of water from its component elements, which are hydrogen and oxygen. The one that follows, you see hydrogen ion combining with hydroxyl. That tells you the reaction is neutralization. The heat absorbed, you can see the delta H there is positive. The heat absorbed during the combination of hydrogen and hydroxyl to give you a molecule of water. A molecule of water, that is an enthalpy change of neutralization. Enthalpy of neutralization, or heat of neutralization. The next one, oxygen combines with carbon. Burning of a substance, that is heat of combustion. Heat of combustion. And the last one, which is solid, heat of soap. Dissolving in water to form solutions of solution. And you could see a molecule of sodium hydroxide is formed at the end of the reaction. These heat changes, when I say standard conditions, I mean if temperature, which is room temperature, effects on the surrounding. Effect it has on the surrounding. If the reaction is endothermic, it absorbs heat from the surrounding. The surrounding is affected, meaning that the surrounding environment becomes cool. Why a reaction that involves evolution of heat, it will raise the temperature of the surrounding. That is the meaning. And we can give some chemical examples of this. When you get your solid sodium hydroxide and water is added to it, you will hear hissing sound. And when you move your hand towards it, you will feel that that place is hot. It is being liberated to the surrounding like that. Another example, reaction between an acid and a base is also, affecting the environment because it evolves heat to the surrounding. Now, why some other reactions absorb four, calcium trihydrocarbonate four, that is CaCO3. It is needed for the change to occur. That is an endothermic change or an endothermic reaction. I have some examples of exothermic and endothermic reactions here. Combustion of oxygen, is an exothermic change. It is liberated to the surrounding. Why the other one done? Nitrogen combining with oxygen to give you nitrogen 4 oxide. To give you nitrogen 2 oxide, it is absorbed from the surrounding for the reaction external influences. Only that we are considering it for thermochemical reaction. Now, another thing that we can use in determining if a reaction is exothermic or it is endothermic is, you know, for chemical reaction to take place between atoms of elements or of substances, you know, we have stages. The stages are, we are going to have breaking of bond. Breaking of bond. For example, if hydrogen wants to combine with chlorine, hydrogen molecule will break down to give you hydrogen atoms. Chlorine molecule also breaks down to give you chlorine atoms. There will now be recombination. They will now, that is indicated as enthalpy change is positive. Enthalpy change is positive there. Now, the other one is bond forming. Association of the atoms formed from the molecule of the substance. Bond forming is an exothermic change. It liberates heat to the surrounding. This also confirms law of conservation of energy. The energy employed in breaking the bond, if the bond breaking energy is greater than the bond forming energy. Why is this so? Bond breaking energy is positive. Bond forming energy is negative. You know, when positive is more than negative, the summation is going to create an endothermic change. Again, when the bond breaking energy is more than the bond forming energy, such a reaction proceeds, you know, by endothermic means. But if the bond breaking energy is less than the bond forming energy, positive less than negative, the summation is going to give you negative. It is liberated to the surrounding. Now, what are the points you need to know for thermochemical reaction? A reaction in which you see in front of it delta H, in which you see in front of it in which delta H is negative, that is exothermic reaction. Reaction in which you are told it is lost to the surrounding, that is an exothermic reaction. The reaction in which you are told it is absorbed from the surrounding, that is an endothermic change. The reaction in which it is known to you the heat formation of products, that will be an exothermic change or exothermic reaction. That is it about energy. Note it, energy is neither lost nor gained, but we have energy conversion. You can see in these thermochemical reactions, chemical energies are changing into, you know, the progress of the chemical reaction is measured by the heat change between the system and the surrounding. That is about energy changes and its effect. Now, I want to assess this class. You'll be, any question asked about a reaction or a diagram in which you see question mark? Because I'm trying to get a marker. You are going to tell me the type of reaction in which that chemical equation illustrates. The chemical reaction in which you can see question mark is which type of change? You can see arrows are pointing inward. Heat is gained. That is an endothermic reaction, not exothermic. You can see again the one I put question mark. Which type of reaction is this one? Also, this is an endothermic change because the product, the enthalpy of formation of product, is greater than that of reactant. It's also an endothermic change. Thank you for listening.